Showing Time with Pastor Anthony Melchizedek. Get answers to questions regarding the kingdom of God and general life issues. Today's question.
Well, the word rapture is not found in the Bible, unless somebody has literally introduced it. But when you read Genesis through to Revelation, you don't find the word rapture. Well, people use the word caught up, that Paul used in Thessalonians to mean rapture. But the theory says it is unbiblical. In the first place, rapture is unbiblical. It's not in the Bible. Let me explain. The theory says that, or the doctrine says that, Jesus will come secretly and then steal or rapture some people away. We will not see them. And then he'll take them away. Give those who will not be ready by then 7 years to repent or to make amends. Then at the end of the 7 years, Jesus will come back again for the final harvest. Now, let me ask a question. Assuming a pilot is flying an airplane and he is ready on the raptured, so-called raptured day, and Jesus had to rapture him away, what happened to the airplane? Or a car, a driver is driving a car, passenger car, train, etc. Any moving thing, people are in it. And that person has to be raptured. What happens to it? God is a wise God. The theory of rapture is not biblical. This is what is going to happen, and this is biblical. Jesus will come one, according to Acts chapter 1, when he was going, two angels came, stood by the disciples and told the disciples, this same Jesus, not another Jesus, that you see him go will come in like manner. As in, the method you saw him go, that is the same method he will come. So Jesus will come. And when he was going, the disciples and those around saw him. So when Jesus is coming, everybody will see him. In fact, that one is also biblical. And then when he comes, he will not touch this earth. He will hang mid-air because sin is still on the earth. Angels will be sent to come and then call the names of the dead saints. They will get up. Their skin will change. Those of us who may be living at the time, we also will be transformed. Then we will meet the Lord in there, go and spend 1,000 years in heaven. Then after the 1,000 years, according to Revelation chapter number 20, when we are coming back after that vacation, the devil will be released from his prison. Literally, when we are away for the vacation, there will not be any human being on earth. All the dead sinners, all the sinners will be dead. So, but when we are coming, Jesus will resurrect all of them. And then Satan will mobilize them that they want to come and attack the city of gold that we will be bringing. And then God or Jesus will rain fire upon all the earth. And that fire is what we refer to as hellfire, to burn the devil and to burn the sinners. Then he will take sin out of the earth, remake this world anew, restore it as in Eden time, and then place the capital, the New Jerusalem, on this earth, and we will live here forever. So we will not go and live in heaven permanently. We'll go for vacation, but we will live here as it was before sin entered the world, forever and ever. So God is not going to give anybody a second chance. If you die today, that is your end. If you die today and you are a righteous person by the grace of God, your name is in the book of life. The next time you open your eyes will be a transformation of flesh, and then you are ready for the 1,000-year vacation. When you die today and you are not with Christ, when you wake up again, that will be your payday, your punishment hour. So there's not going to be any 7 years of remedial actions and all that. That is not scripture. And this theory is, excuse me for my language, with a greater respect of those who believe in it, this theory is from the devil. He's creating this idea so that you will believe that there's going to be a second chance. So if you are not able to make it during the first chance, you still have a second chance. There's not going to be any second chance. It's not biblical. Absolutely, it is not.